harsh words from Fox host Neil Cavuto to those who are still refusing the vaccine or spreading misinformation about it, which really seemed directed right at his own colleagues.
Life is too short to be an ass. Life is way too short to be ignorant of the promise of something that is helping people worldwide. Stop the deaths. Stop the suffering. Please get vaccinated. Please.
After testing positive for COVID, Cavuto, who has battled multiple sclerosis for 25 years, credited the vaccine for saving his life. Joining us now is Brian Stelter, CNN chief media correspondent and anchor of Reliable Sources. Life's too short to be an ass. Am I wrong, Brian? Was that literally directed exactly at the other anchors of Fox News?
Based on my reporting about Fox for years, yes, I believe it was. Cavuto has tried to speak out about nonsense inside Fox, inanity inside Fox. But it's a remarkable situation inside Fox where you have these other hosts who are proudly unvaccinated or who are standing up against what they believe are tyrannical vaccine mandates. It's almost a hostile work environment, you know, where you've got your colleagues who are frankly prolonging the pandemic and causing more people to get sick. I mean, look what happened over the weekend. Lisa Booth bragging to her on Fox's air saying, I'm doubling down on being unvaccinated as a middle finger to Joe Biden. And you're thinking to yourself, well, Fox has a vaccine mandate. You either have to get vaccinated or you have to get tested every day. You want to know the loophole? A lot of these stars on Fox get paid millions of dollars. They sit in their own private studios. They're in their own home studios or they're in remote locations. So they never go into Fox's office. So they don't actually have to get vaccinated or get tested every day. So at least thankfully they're not breathing the same air as Cavuto. And hopefully, you know, they're not going to get anybody sick. But it's so striking how hostile this is. Thank goodness we work at a place where there's not these crazy daily arguments about whether to stay safe.
You mentioned what, because look, there's two completely different views that you're hearing from Fox. Neil Cavuto's really, it seems, in the minority. You mentioned Lisa Booth's comments. Let's get the full experience of those.
I, as a 36-year-old woman with no underlying conditions, have a 99.97% chance of survival against COVID. So I was on the fence because it didn't make sense to get vaccinated for a virus that is not a threat to my life, nor one that I fear. But now I'm doubling down as a giant middle finger to Joe Biden's tyranny because now it's a fight for freedom.
Mm. A middle finger also, I should mention, to the health of other people and just caring about other human beings.
I think that's
so let's
big
not
story.
Mention that, though.
And her voice is usually much louder than the Cavuto's. That's always been the issue at Fox in the Trump era and beyond. The sane, rational voices are the quiet ones, and the ones that are on another planet are the really loud ones.
Life's too short to be an ass, says Neil Cavuto at Fox. That's like, click, change the station if you're over there. Thank you, Brian. I appreciate it.